नमस्कार। ग्लोबली मोर देन 300 मिलियन पीपल आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम डिप्रेशन। दिस मेक्स इट अ लीडिंग मेंटल डिसऑर्डर थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड। व्हाट हैपन्स इन डिप्रेशन? इन आवर सिस्टम, बिकॉज ऑफ डिप्रेशन, दीज हेल्दी हॉर्मोन्स लाइक सेरोटोनिन एंड डोपामाइन, दे आर नॉट सीक्रेटेड। एंड सो व्हाट हैपन्स? Our body is under more and more negative state. Mood is bad. Mind is disturbed. You are personally feeling sad. You see only negativity all around the world. You have no reason to even smile, no reason to laugh in any case. To cope up with depression, usually people take antidepressant medicines, pills to pop up. And they feel that these pills, which are chemicals, are going to settle the chemicals in the mind. No, but understand, any pill you take, if it has some good effect in some area, it is going to have a very bad effect in another area. Nervous system is shaky, nervous system can't focus well, and things are still bad. These chemical adjustment through pills is a very temporary phenomenon. But understand that yoga is a very strong antidepressant. You should know that when in yoga, person starts using his mind in the right direction, person starts bringing a positive hormones into his body, person's entire lifestyle is so well organized that he is doing certain things which would increase all the secretions properly, hormones start functioning properly when you start doing yoga. And then you see that depression just goes away. Today, we will understand three powerful yoga asanas to cope up and to come out of this depression. The first asana would be Dhanurvakrasana. What happens in depression? Person doesn't like to face the world, person has no energy, person feels tired all the time, person feels like crying all the time. All such things are happening in depression. So, what do we do now? Here is this asana, which is called as Dhanurvakrasana. When you do this asana, it is a compression on the navel region, which is the source of lots of energy. So, you get more energy into your body. Backward bend just represents that you are lifting yourself up. It is upward lifting posture, and that really brings a mood which would be a very positive mood in your system. So now how to do Dhanurvakrasana? Just understand.
Dhanurvakrasana. Lie down on your stomach with your hands by the side. Bend your knees and fold your legs towards the back. Grasp the ankles. Inhaling, raise your head upwards and simultaneously pull your leg upwards. An attitude of willpower is generated naturally in the subconscious while attempting this posture. Maintain this position for 6 seconds, holding your breath. Feel the expansion in your chest and feel the stretch in the chest muscles. Navel area, which is the source of all energies, is compressed and activated. Exhaling, lower the legs and the head. Release the grasp on your ankles and return to the starting posture. Repeat this asana 2 to 3 times. With the practice of this asana, mind becomes more dynamic and energetic over a period of time.
Second asana, Ek Pada Adhomukha Shvanasana. That is one-legged downward dog pose. Now, here what happens is, in our system, because of depression, the neurotransmitters of our brain gets affected. And so, the circulation to the brain is reduced, mind becomes dull, the response is never done quickly, everything is slow and dull. And so, no activity is done as it should be done. Now here, when you do this pose, where you are bending forward, your one leg is up, automatically such a good circulation to the brain goes that person is energized, person feels active, person's brain starts functioning in a very good way, and the upliftment takes place again. So this posture is beautiful posture person should do and benefit. In depression, person has a very low self-esteem, doesn't even think that he is somebody, and that creates a hell of a problem. So here, when you do such a posture, it really improves your self-esteem, because you feel strong, capable, and you feel you can do something. So that's it. You should do this asana and benefit yourself.
Ek pad adhomukh shwan asana. Kneel on the floor, keeping hip width distance between your knees. Your hands placed in line with your shoulder. Slowly take the knee away from the floor, face downward, and head between the arms. Sustain the posture for few seconds as per your comfort. It is also called as mountain pose. Stay there like a mountain, strong and high. Keep lifting your tailbone as high as you can. A feeling of strength naturally generates in this posture. Slowly lift one leg straight up. Stay there for few seconds as per your capacity. More blood is directed to your brain in this posture, and this helps in bringing balance in the activities of brain. Slowly bring your leg down to the initial position. Repeat with other leg. This posture helps in building your endurance and energy.
Third asana. Rather, it's an exercise. It is diaphragmic exercise. Here, what happens is usually in depression, the sleep pattern is disturbed. Our circadian cycle is totally disturbed. When you should be sleeping, you can't sleep. And that affects terribly. In doing this abdominal exercise, it is observed that when person is under negativity, tension, abdomen becomes very tight. Diaphragm hardly moves. And so we have to learn to move this diaphragm strongly. When we are in a lying down position, diaphragm can move 2 inches up and down. When we are in sitting position, it moves 1.5 inches up and down. And when we are standing, 1 inch up and down. So whenever possible, lie down with legs folded and do the movement of diaphragm to remove the stress and tension from that area. And when that happens, this entire circadian cycle becomes normal. Person sleeps at night, works during day, and remains healthy. So let's see how to practice this.
Diaphragmatic exercise. Lie down on your back. Bend both your knees, placing your feet hip width apart, and join your knees. Place your right palm gently on the stomach. Begin with the slow movement of abdomen in and out. Gradually increase the pace of the movement. Do this for 5 to 10 cycles. One movement of up and down is one cycle. Now relax your abdomen and stay there for few seconds in normal breath. This rhythmic diaphragmatic movement facilitates deeper and fuller breathing. This resets your prana, your bioenergy to normalcy, and thereby improving your sleep.
So, practice these three asanas regularly. Rather, I would say everybody should practice these three asanas regularly, because depression can affect anybody. And so, try and practice this. Understand, yoga is the most powerful antidepressant. Follow that, make your life positive, happy, useful, and meaningful. Namaskar.